Good afternoon, all of you. I am Prajakta Patil. I am working as a CSAD in CAC department and a student of MTech 2 second year. Now, today I am going to cover the main topics, that is introduction to Linux environment and GCC. We will see the agenda. Now, introduction to Linux environment, all of you must be aware of the Windows environment, and we will look at the Linux thing. We will look at some text editors, that is VVIM and gedit. We'll write some programs in these text editors and compile them with either GCC or G++. Now, you must be watching the login screen on your computer. I guess all of you must have logged in into the system, as here it is saying that we are assuming no Linux background from all of you. So, be relaxed. Now, we have to start the terminal. I hope you all of you logged in the system. So, we have to start the terminal. Now, what is a terminal? It is a common box through which we can execute some commands. We can through the commands to the operating system, we can launch the applications, or we may execute some programs. For example, in the Windows system, when we double click on some Windows Media Player, it gets started. Same here, if we type some command, the application get launched. Now, you can go to the terminal through application, then accessories and terminal. You can go to the application that you can see on the left corner, in that accessories and that terminal. You will see a white box. There are other ways for opening this. You can also do Alt F2 and can type genome terminal, the same box will get open. Alt F2 will open some, will pop up a small box, in that you can type genome dash terminal, G-N-O-M-E, genome dash terminal, the same white box will get open. So, through this terminal, we will write the code. Now, when you open the terminal, you can see a prompt which is displayed on the terminal. The prompt is made up of some word followed by @ followed by some again word and colon, tilde and $. Now, $ is nothing but a prompt. Now, the word which is word before @ is your username, is the same username using which you have logged in. After @, you can see the machine name, the machine which you are using, and after that the tilde is your home directory. The Linux is made up of a directory like a structure. There is a root directory, the main directory. Inside it has a home, and inside all home directories of all users are maintained. Now, you are currently logged into the home directory of the user you have logged in. Now, you have to work in that home directory only. So, now we have to create one directory inside your home directory. You must be aware of the folder structure of the Windows, where you can store many files. For example, if you want to store the files of say movies and songs, you create separate folders for movies and songs. The same structure maintained in the Linux. You can create the directory using command mkdir, that is a simplest command. Mkdir is nothing but make directory. The syntax is mkdir, the directory name. You can create the name, you can specify maybe your own name, mkdir, and the directory name. Now, after executing mkdir, you on the prompt, you are on the same space or the same position on which you are before executing the command. You are currently working directory is /home/user. You want to go inside the directory which you have created right now. You can use the command cd and directory name. Cd is nothing but a change directory. Change directory and the directory name, the same directory name which you have created right now. So, now inside, you are inside your directory. Now, you will store all files or programs which you will write today. Now, here are some basic Unix commands which you will require for running the Unix system. Now, ls is listing the files in your directory. Currently, if you type ls in the current directory, it will show nothing because you have not created any of the files in the current directory. Now, pwd is displays the present working directory. If you type pwd, it is showing the directory /home/user and your directory. Cd we have just shown, done right now, that is a change directory. Remove, it is removing a file, nothing but deleting a file from the folder. Now, copy is CP is copying a file, then move or MV is a moving a file, that is nothing but a cut paste in the what in the Windows we do. Mkdir we have just, rmdir is nothing but a removing a directory. These are the simple commands for the Linux. Now we want to write a C program. For writing a C program, we can use the different editors. I have also created the directory. I am going inside the directory. Now we will write the program using text editors. There are different text editors maintained with the Unix environment. We will look at the VI and gedit. Now, VI is very powerful text editor. For using VI, we have to create one file that we can create using VI. You can use also VIM. VIM is the latest version. VIM set temp.txt. You will enter in the VI editor. There you can. There are actually two modes, two working modes of the VI: the normal or command mode, or a text mode. In normal mode, the keystrokes, the key which you are pressing, are nothing but the commands you are giving to the VI editor. And in the text mode, these are the simple letters you want to type. You can enter into the command mode by typing the I. You will enter into the insert mode. There you can type anything. If you want to save the file, you have to come again back from the insert mode by pressing escape. And if you want to save, then colon WQ enter. It exits from the VI after saving the file. If you don't want to save the file, just colon Q enter. If you want to see the view the file you have just written right now, you can say cat temp.txt. This is the same file, it is displaying the same file on the console that we have written right now. Now again I will open the file. First you will find it little bit difficult while working with this editor, but after practicing you will find this is very great. Now I will write some lines over here. Now, the various commands we will see. For deleting, you have you want to enter some commands. So, come out of the insert mode. So, that is a command mode. If you go on some line, the green cursor is showing the line which I am highlighting. If you press double D, it will delete the line. Currently, my cursor is on the first line. If I press double D, then it deletes the line, the line which cursor is highlighting. Now in this editor, they have given the facilities. You can move here and there using the arrow keys which are provided on the keyboard. Previously, you have to use different commands for doing this, but you can use the arrow keys which are on the keyboard for moving up and down. If you want to search a particular word, you have to come again out of the insert mode and press slash, look at the down, is it visible? Now, if I want to search for a word, I'll come out of the insert mode, I'll press slash and I'll put the word which I want to search, enter, it will highlight the word. It will go at the start of the word where it found the word. And if you want to go to the particular line, you can do this by colon and a line number in the say any integer. It will go to the line number. You can study other commands from the VI on these links. The first link is very useful. It gives almost all commands which you can run on VI. Gedit is another GUI based editor. This you will find a little bit easy because it has the same structure, what you use in the notepad in the Windows structure. So you can open the gedit and file name, and you will do anything on gedit and a file name. It will open a notepad like structure, and there you can do anything like search and replace, then editing, cut, copy, paste. It can displace the line numbers also. When you write programs in different languages, it also highlight the syntax, various syntax. You can directly have a print option in the file menu. Then I set the search and replace, then bracket matching. Now you will think if this GUI editor is available, then why to use this VI VM? Because sometimes what happens, the machine we get is just has the command mode and not the GUI mode. In that case also you can use VI and edit all files, all system files that you want to edit. Even if the GUI is not present, VI and VIM use VI or VIM can suffice. Now we'll go to the actual. Now we are very comfortable with the Linux environment and the terminal and the editors. Now we will use these editors for writing the C programs. Now GCC is nothing but a GNU compiler collection, which is a compiler system developed by GNU project. It is used to compile the programs written in different programming languages. Now here is the first program, that is program1.c. Now you can write this the same program using VIM. Just we have seen VIM program1.c. You can type the whole program. It is a very simple program. It is just declaring one variable, printing hello vim, iterating through the loop and printing the various integers, and finally done. You can write this program in one file and save this file using :wq. You have to install one software using apt-get. I'll write here on one notepad. Just type one command: sudo apt-get install build essential. This is for running the program through GCC. Just type this, it will ask for a password, enter 123. Now this is the same program. Now I want to compile this program using GCC compiler. I will use the command GCC program4.c. If the program is perfectly written, that is no syntax error or no any logical error, then it will come out of the command. It shows the prompt. That is, the compilation is successful, no errors. After compiling, it creates one executable file, that is dot out file named as a dot out, which you can run as a dot slash a dot out, which displays the output, actual output of the program, which is expected. If the compilation is successful, then only you can execute this step, dot slash a dot out. By default, it gives the name a to the executable file. If you want to give the different name, then there is a second command. You can GCC program4.c. You can specify -o option and say program4. It is the name that you want to give to the executable file, and you can run as program. If you want to give some different name to the executable file, you can give it through -o option. Now there are some other options for the compilation using GCC. You can compile different source files using GCC and specifying the list of the source files that you want to compile. But here, without specifying any other option, it links those all files together and it creates a simple one executable file. So if you have the different files, say p1.c, p2.c, and if you have main in both the files, then it will not execute successfully, because it tries to link both the files, creating a single output file. I have one example which is not with you. I'll just show you the thing. This is one program, that is program1.c. It may not be with you. Here, the last second last line it is calling print hello function, which is not declared, which is declared in the same file but not defined in the same file. Okay, the print hello function, you cannot see the print hello definition, the definition of this function in the same .c file. I have defined it in another file here. It is just returning or printing goodbye. Now I will compile both the programs together so that GCC will link them together, and it creates a single output file combining both these source files. So it prints everything, and the last function call for printing goodbye, it goes to that file, prints, and again come back. So it is nothing but linking two files using GCC. You can enter the debug mode using minus G option. There are different debuggers present. You can see it in the later presentation. If you want all warnings to be displayed on the screen after compilation, you can give the option say minus wall. It displays all warning options. In the previous example, we have seen that it links all the files together. If you don't want this to be happen, that if you want the different, absolutely different files which have to be compiled together, you have to specify option minus C. After that, all the C files will get compiled, and it forms the .o files. .o files are nothing but object files, and these are simple binary files. These cannot be executed. This again have to be converted into executable files using GCC. Now these are options. You can write various large programs, and can if you have very large program, then you can divide it into two simple small programs. You can link them together. You can debug through minus G options, and the C programming becomes very easy using GCC. Now this is another example, that is .cpp, that is C++ exam. The currently above it is showing IOStream. It is the same, it is header file used in C++. Using namespace std, it is you can say it is a package or a group of variables or maybe definitions that are defined in std library. If you do not specify this using namespace std, the C out and the C in, all these operators are defined in this std, and every time you have to specify std double colon C out, std double colon C in. So when you specify this using namespace std above, the compiler itself search for all this C out and C in the std library, and you will not have to enter it again and again. You can create your own namespace also and use in the program. Now what it is doing, it is just defining a constant and taking the radius of a circle and calculating area, that is nothing but a pi r square, and displaying the same. You can also write this program in the VI editor. Currently I have it, but GCC, it will give I have program 2.cpp, that is a C++ file, the same file that you have in your presentation. I am compiling it with GCC compiler. It will give errors because GCC does not know the header files or any other libraries required for compiling C++ program. So GCC provides the generalized structure. It has G++, sorry, for compiling the C++ program. I'm just typing G++ program 2.cpp. It creates the same .a. output file. The other options and other things are same as GCC, and you can type a.out. It asks for the radius. I'll put say 20, and it displays the area of a circle, that is pi r square. So GCC for different languages, it provides the different set of the compilers that you can use very easily. the structure remains the same, you can use in the different languages. The other things that if you want to change the a dot out file, then the same option minus o option, linking, you can also link the files. You can also go into the debug mode for debugging. Some other interesting thing is some libraries have to be enabled while running the program. For example, thread.cpp, it requires the LP, the pthread library for running the same program. So, it can be run as follows: g++ threads.cpp minus LP thread, because it executes or it has some thread system calls. For that, it requires this system library.